George Kilpatrick, new inspiration for the nation. We are here in Washington, D.C. with none other than Willie Jolly. Willie Jolly is a motivational speaker, a best-selling author. He is the man, and he is the comeback kid. He's here to tell us how to turn setbacks into greenbacks and also how to achieve our SMART goals for 2012. It's a new year. We have new expectations. We've got to get rid of some things that we thought that we couldn't do or that we can do. We've got to make some changes. And this is the year, Willie, that we make some changes. Willie Jolly, we're so glad to have a chance to meet you in the flesh.
It's always a privilege and a pleasure to be with you on the radio. And now we're live together. And greetings to everybody. And, you know, for those who have heard me on George's show before, you know, I always start the same way. I have only just a minute, only 60 seconds, and it forced upon me. Can't refuse it, didn't seek it, didn't choose it, but it's up to me to use it. I must suffer if I lose it, give account if I abuse it, just a tiny little minute, but an eternity is ended. Greetings to everybody.
Willie, this is really a great time for us. You and I, we were talking earlier, and every new year brings new opportunities, and every new year brings new challenges. And I know that for you this year, you're talking about your mission is SMART goals, right? How to achieve what is called SMART goals. You'll tell us what that means. But I want you to give us a sense of where you think we are as individuals. You know, what prevents most of us from getting what we say is most important to us?
I believe that most people are seriously not serious. Okay. And that sounds like a play on words. But what it is that we say we want to do it, but we're not serious about it. And I think that impacts everybody, including moi. You know, I say there are certain things I want to do, and then I have to realize if I was really serious, what would I do? I like to ask, and so I had to ask myself those questions. And I ask myself the question, what do you want? So you know your goal. Number two is, what are you willing to do to get what you want? So you know you have some plan to get to that goal. Then what else could you be doing to get to that goal? Or you could say, what do you want? What are you doing to get to that goal? And then what else could you be doing? And then finally, what are you doing to not get to your goal? So one of the things, I give you an example. I say I'm seriously not serious. I've been saying I was going to lose weight, you know, and I'm going to lose weight. When I started this process of being married 27 years ago, I did not look like I look now. I was a lot thinner. And so last year, I said, I'm losing weight, but I was seriously not serious. We went on a cruise, and then we went on out of the country, and I just didn't get serious. But I'm serious now, so I've got a plan. And then what are the things that I'm doing that not get to my goals? So I can't be eating ice cream at night no more, you know? I have to make a decision that, you know, so get seriously serious about my goals. So I want to encourage people this year that decide what you want so you get clarity on what the goal is that you're trying to achieve. Then ask, what am I doing? What's the plan to get to that goal? And what else could I be doing to get to that goal? And then what am I doing to keep myself, to distract myself from that goal? And sometimes it's the matter of focus. Focusing on something. If you ever go to the circus, you'll see a guy who's spinning seven plates on seven sticks. And that's always like, wow. But if you ever notice him get started, where he walks out and takes the plates out of the stack and the sticks out of the bunch, he takes one stick, he takes one plate, he gets that plate swinging really, really, really good. And then he goes to the second plate. He doesn't try and do them all at the same time. He takes one at a time, gets it spinning real good, then he goes to the second, gets that spinning good. Then all he has to do is touch the first. And then he gets the third one, and he just has to touch the first one and the second one, and vice versa, so forth and so on. So I think that's what I have to encourage people to this year, to get a mindset that I'm going to focus on this one thing first, get it red hot, then I'll get some other things done.
I like what you said about focusing on one thing, getting that really red hot, and then using that then to pull yourself to the next step or the next level. Is it that, Willie, what happens is we get so consumed with wanting to get to the next level that we forget about the basic things that we have to do each and every day to maintain that momentum that is required to get what we say we want.
You know, if you ever look at a football game, sometimes the guy starts to run before he gets the ball. You ever see that?
I've seen it.
All right, and so that's what we sometimes, and that's human nature. We are thinking down the road. We know what's our next step. What do we have to do? And we forget the thing there. So I think that's why it's important to take some time every day to write down what your plan is and what you're planning to achieve that day, and try and get those done as you go along the way. We are in a society where we are bombarded with so much information so quickly, coming at us rapidly. So I don't fault anybody for that. I just say that's something we have to always be mindful that, okay, catch the ball before I start running.
You know, we're talking with Willie Jolly. Willie Jolly, obviously, is a motivational speaker, best-selling author on Sirius Radio as well. And he writes inspirational music. He has a plan, and he's helping us to think about how we can get what we really said we want in 2012. And being the comeback kid, you and I were just talking about the need for comebacks, mm-hmm. the need to be sure of who you are, the need to know that you are not what your last thing was, that you're bigger than anything, that you have to know who you are, that you have to know your brand, you have to know yourself. We were talking about, I was telling you about transition, leaving a pretty secure opportunity, and being a father of four, and having to leave a secure opportunity to now be out here as you are and many other people are an entrepreneur,
right.
And having to shift mindset and shift focus. And so when we are faced with those kinds of positions or those kinds of times in our life when we have to shift our focus and assume a different kind of energy to achieve everything that we have to do, what do you suggest?
Well, what we're talking about is getting out of your comfort zone when life throws you out of the nest. And we're comfortable in the nest and life throws us out of the nest. We have to make a decision. And Bob Johnson said, the same event that can break you can also be the same event that can make you. So the same hammer that breaks the glass is the same hammer that will fashion the steel. And so that same hammer is that event. And so we have to make a decision that where we are is not always where we could be for our future and all that we could be for our potential. And so as I have had setbacks in my life, I keep saying, okay, this setback is not the end of the road. It's a bend in the road. Where is this road going? And if I keep thinking, okay, this road, that was just one chapter in this book. The book is not over. There's a lot left yet to be written, and I'm planning to write it. I'm planning to do it big, bold, and with excitement. So I want to encourage people, if you've had some setbacks, which you probably have, and you're going through a challenging time, don't see this as the end of the story, the end of the road. There's more to come. Just keep moving. Keep moving with a positive attitude and say, something good's coming out of this, and I'm going to make something good come out of this.
In fact, when we say make something good come out of it, so that means you've got to have a plan.
You need a plan, but sometimes I think it's a goal more than a plan. First.
Okay.
The goal, once you know what you want, then you start working on the plan. And sometimes you can't get the plan until you know where you're going. It's like, you came here from Syracuse, you knew you were going to Washington, D.C. You didn't start by saying, well, I'm going out on a road trip somewhere, you know. So you had a goal where you were going to go, and then you got a plan how to get here and how to use the time effectively getting here. So I think you do need a plan, you know, plan your work your plan. On my website, if everybody will go to my website, I think we have a place there, and if not, send us an email for the 10 steps to make this the best year in your life. And one of those steps is decide what you want, write it down, be specific, and then when you work your plan, you plan your work and work your plan, that's part of it. It's some really good steps. I don't have them right in front of me right now, but all 10 of them are very, very good. So I encourage people to get that.